And Nauvoo-Colusa Public Schools, unvaccinated staff are ignoring Illinois' requirement for weekly COVID-19 testing.
And Nuisance 5, the superintendent says that it puts him in a difficult position. WGEM's Rebecca Duffy is back from Nauvoo tonight. She joins us in studio with more. Rebecca.
Dylan and Mackenzie, Nauvoo-Colusa Superintendent Kent Young says he is concerned about losing state funding as the district is already on probation for not complying with the governor's mask mandate. But he also wants to follow his board's decision.
Laura Aitchison is a second grade teacher at Nauvoo-Colusa Elementary School.
I love teaching. I feel like it's my calling and my gift to the world, my gift to students.
Aitchison is not vaccinated for COVID-19 and she is not getting tested for it despite the governor's orders. She says she is not alone.
We could literally lose, I'm not going to use numbers, but many teachers over this.
Last night, the school board voted to accept a proposition from Aitchison and 8 other staff members, where under the Healthcare Right of Conscience Act, staff members will not be forced to follow Pritzker's orders for vaccination or testing.
Nauvoo-Colusa Superintendent Kent Young says he's in a difficult position right now as he has to follow the decision made by the school board while pushing back against the state's executive orders.
I mean, it's a challenge because, you know, obviously you have to follow the what the school board wants, and then the state's telling me to do something differently, and that is a challenge to be in right now.
Before last night's board decision, Nauvoo-Colusa was already on probation for not following the state's mask mandate. The district was given until October 31st to make changes or face losing recognition status and state funding. Although Young says the district needs state funding to survive, he will be following the school board's decision.
The school board is, you know, who I work for, and whatever decisions they make, then I follow those.
Young says he wished his school district had more guidance from the Illinois State Board of Education throughout this process. Rebecca Duffy, WGEM News.